American Indians' contributions to the world. OCO family, this session will be on barbecue and its origins. We know how much of a staple barbecuing or cooking out is and has been in our culture as melanated American Indians. And so does the whole world, because they always trying to be invited to the cookout or calling the pigs on us for having one. Well, barbecuing is indigenous to all of the Americas, North, South, and the islands in between. There's a couple different stories on its origins, which I will touch on shortly. The term barbecue refers to an outdoor pit or grill for cooking meat over a fire. The word can also mean the method of cooking or social gathering where food is cooked in this manner. The Maya, whose civilization arose in about 1500 BC in Mesoamerica, and the Aztec, whose empire was established in the same area beginning about AD 1100, were known to roast meat over an open fire on framework of green wood sticks. The Taino of the Caribbean, whom Columbus and his crew encountered, introduced the barbecue to Europeans. Early engravings by explorers show indigenous people from this area roasting meat on wooden frames of green wood. Although there is no evidence the indigenous people of the West Indies were cannibals, one of these engravings shows them cooking a human leg, perhaps to make the artists' voyages seem more exciting and to dehumanize the Indian people encountered. So the Spanish word claimed to be the origin actually come from the Caribbean Taino Indians, who cooked on high wooden racks above burning wood. They called these racks barbacoas. Columbus brought this back to Spain, and the Spaniards eventually brought the pigs to Florida, which multiplied throughout the Southeast, and they were hunting for both meat and out of practical need to keep down the populations, as feral pigs are the most destructive. Also, the Taino word barbecue, which means the sacred fire pit. To understand the French claim, you first have to know that the first barbecues were fire pits over which whole pigs were roasted. In South Carolina, pigs were plentiful, but there was not a lot of salt, so curing wasn't a good option. When you caught a pig, you needed to cook the whole thing and eat it as quickly as possible, or they'll go to waste. Add some vinegar and peppers to the mix, and you can get a little better shelf life, plus some vitamin C. Mustard was added at some point too. But how was the word born? One theory is that it came from the French words barbecue, which translates loosely into from beard to tail. So you get it, the whole pig from its beard to its tail. Those who subscribe to this theory says that it refers to the practice of roasting the whole pig, which makes sense. The French had little influence on the region compared to the Spanish. However, it was the Spanish who brought the pigs in the first place, so most subscribe to the Spanish origin. The way I see it, no matter who created the word, the culture is still ours. Peace, love, and power, family. Enjoy the rest of the video.
What's up, cousin? How you doing, boy?
Cousin!
What's up, cousin?
What's up?
Boy, I ain't seen you and I don't know where.
Yeah.
Damn. That's a pretty girlfriend you got here, boy. Y'all make a good-looking couple, too, boy. So what's your name, cousin?
Lucky. Little Lucky?
Oh, Lucky. Yeah. Yeah, with a lady like this? Shit. I call you Lucky, too. What's your name, sweetheart?
Justice.
Mm-hmm. You mean like the law, huh?
Mm-hmm.
How you get a name like that?
You don't want to know that story. But anyway, this is my friend, Isha.
Hey, babe.
And it's my husband, Chicago.
Shot-town. How you doing, father?
Son of a...
How you doing? So, cousin.
Yeah.
What's your name? Just call me Cutting Pete.
Cutting
Pete.
Cutting Pete.
Look at y'all. Come on here, man. I want y'all to meet some family, man. Over here we got Aunt Dessa, Uncle Herb, and Aunt Pearl. And that's Uncle Fred, and his wife Will. That's Cousin Isaac, Cousin James, Cousin Quap. What's up, Quap? And them kids. I don't know all their names. Bunch of bread snatchers. And sitting over here, we got Aunt April, we got Aunt May, And we got Angel.
All right.
Yes.
I call the camera sister.
That's right.
Look at it.
Ain't that pretty?
How y'all doing?
Yes, sir. Uh-huh. How you doing?
Ooh, sure look good over there.
No? Well, go on over there and help yourself.
You sure?
You family, ain't you?
It's cool?
Yeah, boy, you better go get you something to eat.
All right,
go get your baby on here with him. I'm going to play some cards myself. Yes, sir.
Bye. Look at them. Don't they make such a cute cup?
Are you all in love?
Yeah.
Baby, what would you know about love?
Nothing.
Well, how can you be in love if you don't know nothing about it?
Just the way things go.
Are you all married?
Yeah.
You're young. How long you been married?
About 6 months now. Mm-hmm. Oh, I don't wear it all the time.
You don't mind if she doesn't wear your ring?
No, he don't mind.
I think he can answer for himself, if he's a real man.
Well, no, man.
Shoot, my husband would kill me if I didn't wear no ring.
I heard
kill
that.
And I know that's right.
Gotta eat to live.
Well, why are you so skinny then? Oh, you're so cute, baby. Can I hold it for you?
Ooh, I heard that. Uh-oh,
hospital. Hey, you be dating a professional, man, huh? Doctors, lawyers, pharmacists, street pharmacists. I knew you was like that.
Here, I'll take her now.
You're so cute, you sure?
So precious. What's her name?
Her name is Imani.
Hi, Imani.
Hi, so cute. You get you, Mom.
So you got a kid, huh?
Why you ask me that?
She look like the type.
And what's the type?
I don't know. This. You just walking by. You the type.
Anyway. You got any kids?
Hell no, I ain't got no kids. I don't even like kids.
Sure don't look like that to me. This here is kind of cool. You ever been to one of these?
No. I ain't got much family. Family I do have ain't this close.
I ain't never seen so many black folks in one spot and it ain't no fight. Get back to these street pharmacists that you used to see.
Let me tell you something. Only went out with one. He was my first boyfriend, my first love. He meant a lot to me.
So you was in it for the money, huh?
Wait a minute, now you're getting too damn personal.
Okay.
The fuck you know? You don't even keep your fucking nails clean.
Remember them good old block parties and cookouts. Everybody on the block party and cookout. Nobody get shot during the cookout. Maybe a fight niggas box during the cookout.
Smoking sessions with Chief Pressure.